the not too distant future, next Sunday AD, there was a guy named Joel, not too different from you or me. He worked at his Monic Institute, just another face in a red jumpsuit. He did a good job cleaning up the place, but his boss didn't like him, so they shot him into space. We'll send him cheesy movies, the worst we can find. He'll have to sit and watch them all, then we'll monitor his mind. Now keep in mind, Joel can't control where the movies begin or end, because he used those special parts to make his robot friends. Robot, we'll call Cabot. Gypsy.
Hi, girl.
Tom Servo. Cool. If you're wondering how he eats and breathes and other science facts, then repeat to yourself, it's just the show. I should really just relax. For Mystery Science Theater 3000.
Hi everybody, I'm Joel Robinson, and these are my robots and friends, Gypsy, Crow, and
Hi.
Tom Servo, and it's casual day up here on the Satellite of Love, so for this segment, we're gonna wing it.
Sure.
Oh, it sounds like fun.
Fine.
It's great.
Oh,
good.
Yep.
Uh-huh. So, winging it.
Huh?
What?
What?
Nothing.
Oh, I thought you were...
No.
Hey!
What?
Oh, I forgot.
Well,
commercial sign in 5 seconds. Commercial sign now. We'll be right back.
What she said.
Pretty.
Hey, look at that!
Oh, the Thompson twins are calling.
Yes, gotta go. Yes, Joel, insert perfunctory acknowledgement here. Joel, my invention today is for all the right reasons. Because stress levels aren't high enough in America, because people need to know how very important you are, and because you may be in line for a movie when that important project deadline comes and goes, I'm talking about the cellular desk. You see, with the cellular desk, I can live my job. Why, I can take an intimidating meeting anywhere. Why, just today, I was out for a walk, going through some files, and I realized that it had been a while since Frank's last employee review. Frank, could I see you in my office?
I'm right here.
Ah, Frank. Take a seat. Frank, I was just going through some files, and I realized it had been a while since your last review. Frank, could I see the Frank file,
please? I'm right here.
Ah, uncooperative. Hostile, uncoordinated. Oh, Frank, Frank, Frank. Well, Bear Witches,
whew, I'm glad we're hourly.
Yeah. You know, John Lennon said, sirs, instant karma's gonna get you, but now you can get instant karma.
That's right, Joel. What goes around comes around, but now you don't have to wait for it.
And no more confusion about what incident correlates to what action. Mm-hmm. Just watch.
Oh, say, Joel, I just sent my whole allowance to Sally Struthers.
Oh, to sponsor a child.
No, for her. I just feel sorry for her.
Sure, we all do. Well, let's check out what your karma is,
okay,
mister.
Simply pour contents into a medium-sized mixing bowl, add water, and presto, there's your instant karma.
Wow! Strawberry licorice, great!
Wow! How about this? Servo, I cleaned up your room today because I know your arms are useless and everything.
Oh, thanks, I think. Oh,
no problem.
All right, let's see what happens. Add a little water to the instant karma. Okay, anything happening?
Joel, I can't really explain it, but I've got this incredible sense of inner peace and well-being.
And a Snickers bar. Here you go, Crow.
Lucky duck. Wow,
you know,
man.
Tom Servo, there's also bad karma.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, remember the other day when you borrowed Crow's Dan skin? You stretched it and then pitted it out. Well, let's see what happens. We'll add a little water here.
What can possibly happen to me for that one?
Yep, here it comes.
Oh no, my aunt's coming to take me to the Michael Bolton concert. Oh man, I'm really sorry.
Well, we've got some pretty good karma going up here on the satellite of love. What do you think, sirs?
Think you've got good karma, eh? Then how come you're going to be watching another Hercules film? And the very first Hercules film, the one that started it all? Well, we all shine on, don't we, Mr. Robinson? Frank, send him the movie.
I'm right.
Frank? Absent.
Hey, it looks like a high school play.
Remember, today's Hercules made from genuine Steve Reeves parts.
Sylvia Kachina says Sylvia's...
My movie has a first name. It's O-S-C-A-R.
Real musical, huh? Stephen Hawking presents The Silly String Theory.
Hey, look, there's the constellation Pisces right below Taurus the Bull.
Oh, now that's not the thought. No. I don't think that.
Oh. Ted Turner's colorizing the universe now.
Hercules! Gets bigger. Last night, I think we've seen this all before.
Oh, he's the finder of lost loves.
Yeah, that's James Francis.
James Francis.
Where's the bouncing ball? Are we supposed to be singing now? God's too.
Yet even he suffered from painful hemorrhoids.
You know, I got the feeling Hercules is going to learn an important lesson and kick some serious butt.
My mortal weakness is cheesecake. Let's watch on.
Oh, I hope they aren't Herc's mortal weakness.
Pan flute master Zamphir was arrested today, naked and drunk, running through a goat herd.
What? Flicker! No!
Kibbles and bits, kibbles and bits. Gotta get me some kibbles and bits.
Put it in second!
That's a guy.
It's a student driver.
Hey, she dropped an egg.
Say.
Hey, Herc, got a match?
Not since Superman died.
Well, that's either Herc or Joe Piscopo. Can't tell.
Great shot.
Wait, this is ancient Greece. They didn't have ruins yet.
Eddie Rabbit.
I'm driving my life away. Huh?
Oh, it's a Dodge. Ram tough.
I'll just chuck her.
Hey, who's gonna pay the fare here?
Why, it's a Comfo Rest adjustable rock.
Does this bug you, Flink?
I went home with you?
I thank you. And I thank the gods for having brought you here today and for saving me.
I must admit I was frightened for you, watching those runaway horses.
Have I mentioned I'm immense and immortal?
How do you feel?
Better.
Did I get anything on my butt?
I'm still trembling, I guess. What's the matter? Why do you sit and stare at me like that?
Well, I don't know it.
So few women come this way.
With so few clothes.
And so?
As long as you're here, I might as well. I never saw a girl more beautiful.
Oh. Sweet talker.
I've come a long way. Seeing you is worth it.
How simple men are.
Tell him, sister.
As though I were a plant or an animal.
Can I water you?
Still, I thank you, you know.
Oh, it looks like an early Baywatch.
Don't thank me for it.
Thank my personal trainer.
So, want to look for agates or something?
You couldn't be anyone but Hercules the Theban.
Thank you.
I know you're expected. Everything will change, they say.
Holy cow, I'm hungry. I gotta go.
By the gods, everything's burnt by this time.
Still, Lassie will taste good right now.
No.
Sit.
Well done, perhaps.
Mm. Hey, want some meat?
No paste, pecan sauce. Get the rope.
Will you have a piece?
Of that?
Go on.
Come on, taste it all.
Yeah, this is really weird, Herc.
Go on.
No more, thank you.
I'm on Jenny Craig.
I will start where your lips have touched.
Oh. Why, how dare you be so audacious?
I'm too hungry to help it.
Hey, it's my piece of meat. I'll bite it where I want to.
Hey, as long as you're over there, hook me a primo out of the fridge, will you?
Pig.
For anybody?
Oh, wouldn't you know, a flat. Hey, you got a box wrench?
That is no work for a princess. Yes, you are Iole, daughter of Peleus, king of Jolco. The royal standard on the chariot told me your name.
I used to lift with your brother.
Here, let me do it. I can work much faster.
There's lots of time to return to a city that I hate so.
Detroit?
That's no way to welcome a stranger.
Only you've no right to be here.
Your father knows about it.
He didn't ask you. It was a question of teaching the art of war to a fetus, my brother, and you are.
A fetus?
Isn't that the same thing?
No. You know the story of my family.
A man named Brady.
Somebody spoke to you about us.
Did Jean tell you I liked you?
You remember it well, then?
Yes.
Was it really so bad?
Excuse me while I have a strange interlude.
I remember it now.
Uh-oh.
I remember all that went on. Is it wrong to be as happy as I was then? But the gods won't answer that question.
It's a simple yes or no would have been fine.
Thank you for me when I ask. I was only a child that day 10 years ago.
Previously on Hercules.
It was such a happy afternoon for me. We were returning from the hunt with my uncle Aeson, who was king of Jolco at that time. He insisted that his son Jason ride in his chariot, together with my brother Iphitus, my father, and I.
And the horses, don't forget us!
At our side rode the captain of the escort, Chiron, who had had angry words with the king on the previous day.
I'm angry.
Though we did not know what it was about. In the woods, we suddenly saw a platoon of soldiers coming toward us.
Hey, I found a pack of Trojans in the road!
A man in chains.
Look what you did, bad!
My uncle stopped the chariot. I tried to see the face of the prisoner, but he knelt with his head bent very low. The king whispered something in my father's ear, and my father got down from the chariot and went to talk with the officer of the platoon.
But first he pulled his skirt out of his underpants.
That happens.
What is he charged with?
Blocking the road.
He killed a woman and robbed her of what little money she had, Your Excellency.
I did that thing.
Wrap him up, I'll take him.
You would like to kill, eh?
To kill. That was the only word I was able to understand of the brief conversation that followed. But I knew somehow that the man must be condemned to death.
It's a murderer, nothing to worry about.
My father came back to the chariot and whispered something to my uncle.
Excuse me, are you Hector Elizondo?
The king shook his head and we started off again. The thought of that prisoner's death swept over me like a bad omen.
Three, the final conflict.
Dark and stormy night.
Later on, my sleep was filled with nightmares. The memory of what had happened in the woods would not leave me. Again and again, I pictured what would certainly be the end of that terrible story.
Yeah, never eat Mexican at bedtime.
The condemned man brought to the place of execution. The executioner advancing to him, grasping his axe, lifting the axe and me powerless to help.
I dreamed I kissed Gavin MacLeod!
Scream, I heard other screams echoing from the farthest end of the palace. My terror was even greater when I noticed that my nurse's bed was empty.
Yeah, those were a real servant problem in ancient Greece.
I decided to put on some socks. My feet were freezing.
Out of my mind with fear, I ran to the throne room.
It's a going out of business sale. We've lost our empire and everything is priced to move.
I could scarcely see the body of the king as they carried him out amidst the clamor and confusion.
Oh boy.
My father stood there petrified.
Oh, who bled here? Give me some club soda.
Then he turned and a look of fear crossed his face. But the stand behind the throne was empty.
Looks like a Jim Dine sculpture.
The golden fleece was gone.
But I digress. How was your day?
Jason escaped with the golden fleece. And Kiran too, but you know the rest.
So that's why Kiran was accused of killing the king, kidnapping Jason, and stealing the golden fleece.
Yes.
And for what reason?
For revenge.
And do you believe that?
It's important. Do you think that people lie?
No, never. Yes, always.
But I've heard it wasn't Kiran who killed the king. It was the king's brother who murdered him.
That's not true!
Why do you relive the story if it's not true?
Hey, my turd bag's full over here. Could you empty this thing?
They all speak about the past here. The murder happened to put my father on his brother's throne. But I know he wouldn't do that. It's tragic. Now that the golden fleece is gone, he must officiate.
Oh.
No one tries to aid them, why they don't care. My poor father's above your suspicions.
For all our sakes, I hope so.
Anyway, this should hold till you get to Sparta.
I see you're joking. I remember somebody saying you were a friend of Kiran. Have you come for revenge? And more suffering?
Wait, would you allow me to accompany you?
On piano?
Please.
Let's start the movie.
I'm not much of a carpenter. It won't work. It's better to let me take you back to Jolko.
There's a new Sophocles play opening tonight.
Please.
Pretty Please with Herc on top.
I would like to see your eyes with happiness there in place of hate, because I can understand just the way you feel. But I will help you now. Believe me, I'll protect you.
Hercules, tell me again, why didn't we take the chariot?
Hush. Can we stop at a Super America soon?
No, darling, it's okay. Just hush.
Hercules now concludes his broadcasting day. Good night, and may Herc bless.
Where is the sample?
Oops.
Boy, I'd hate to shovel those steps, you know, just... Whoa.
Hiya, Hercules, reservation for two. Might be under Heracles there.
Oh, no, really. They take this cheese, they get it really hot, and then they pour Radzina all over the top, and then they light it, and they say, Opa.
As the worm eats the fruit that matures,
Men
stalk their prey. He will come here for you. When you see the man, he will wear one sandal. Wait no longer.
She has a creamy strawberry center.
Will you escape destruction? He wears but a single sandal. When he comes, take care.
But why does he hate me like that?
He does not know you are the man he hates.
Oh, Father. How can you take stock in these oracles, and this one isn't even pretty?
Destiny knows all about all men, and when your time comes, you too will know.
You witch, get away, do you hear?
They will speak no more. When someone angers the gods, they finish.
Why, no!
Can we not fight just as once?
Gods and their oracles. They are the gods' messengers.
Just asking about the oracle.
I shall give an order that any man coming to Jolko wearing one sandal will be put to death immediately.
Hello?
You!
How long have you been there?
Who is that?
Hercules, the master of arms that you sent for.
Hercules the Theban.
Hey, I'm no Phoebe.
Come forward.
May I take your luggage?
You're next.
Welcome to Jolko.
A planned community.
They say you're almost a god. Well, then, why aren't you invisible?
Stop it, Apetus. This man saved my life today.
Marvelous. That's a way to make a fine impression.
You'd better listen to what I have to say to Hercules.
No.
Because it concerns you, too. You're here to reinforce Jolko.
Done. And?
Hercules will guide you until you're able to reign. But he must show you. Because I want to give the throne up.
Father!
Princess,
because
please.
Because each year I grow more anxious. I can't go on being king forever. I can't go on.
I'll go on.
Father, you've been drinking too much tonight.
I guess you're right, but it won't stop it, can't you see? Hercules, I must beg you to help us at Jolko.
Just said you were drinking too much, jeez.
You must help to keep the throne for my boy here.
If I find that you are loyal, I will grant you anything you want out of Jalko.
Anything?
I hope you sleep well. One moment. He may be an imposter. How do I know?
Have another drink, Dad.
I saw him. My horses, they were running away.
Here, bench press me.
He stopped my horses. I knew who he was.
Certainly.
Well, he could be Roy Rogers.
Well, I feel grateful. But I can't depend on the eyes of a girl.
What are you trying to say?
I'm a pig.
Nothing. Don't be upset about it, Yole.
Why don't we talk about it later?
Well then, let me do it, Father.
You a billiards man, Herc?
All right then, prove you're so fearless. Come on.
What are you doing? That's my good spear.
I'll bend it back later.
Good, Hercules.
Sit, Hercules.
Enough now. Yole may show you to your quarters. Until tomorrow, Peleus.
Well, here's where the working out pays off.
Why do you have to treat me as if I were a baby? He's taken you in just as he's charmed Yole. And you hate him because you're weak and impulsive.
I'm not, am
I? Hercules is a guarantee. He's more than a match to play against Argo, Laertes, Tepe, the Dioscuri, and all those others who plan to get the throne of Jalko. I want that throne for you.
Lou, I want that throne.
Joel, what was the deal with the ancient Greeks, huh?
Hey, be careful. You're talking about the ancient Greeks, Crow.
Yeah. But this constellation jazz, come on! After 2,000 years, can we finally admit the Emperor has no clothes? 4 stars.
Oh, it's a great bear.
Right, or Cassiopeia, whatever the heck that is.
Hey, what about Orion?
Okay, I'll give you Orion. I gotta admit, Orion's right, but the rest of them, it just doesn't...
If I could step in here, please, lest we despoil the reputation, Crow, of the founders of democracy too much, the reason you don't see the same figures in the night sky is because new constellations have never been identified to reflect modern tastes and sensibilities.
You've done that?
I've done that. A little help here, Joel? Watch carefully. The first grouping of stars found in the southern sky forms a constellation for even the simplest hayseed, Crow. Yes, it's a ham sandwich. Fascinatingly, the star to the left of the main group forms a perfect pickle. Next. As winter gives way to spring, the eastern sky is ablaze with the glory of the new Christy Minstrels.
New Christy Minstrels? Who would have ever thought?
Well, that's why you need people like me and the Greeks, Joel. Next.
Oh, brother.
Sophist. Doughty seamen just may be tempted to once again navigate by the stars when they recognize in this group of 11, Guernica, Picasso's cubist masterpiece portraying the horrors of the Spanish Civil War.
Well, talk about your modern sensibilities. Really good job, Tom Sermo, for these renovations of old constellations.
And I've salvaged the reputation of the ancient Greeks.
Well done.
Tom, I regret my earlier sniping, and if you'll allow me, I got a constellation here, Joel.
Oh, well, that's really...
Here, it's a pencil.
Oh.
The eraser's almost gone.
Crow, don't mock me. You're playing with fire.
Hey, 2 dots. It's a pencil. What could be more modern?
I weep for the death of the spirit and the soul.
Hey, who doesn't? We'll be right back.
Ennui.
Where's my Remy Martin?
Friends are visiting from Europe.
You're drinking my commode.
It is late for you to visit here. What is it, Eurystheus?
Nothing, but you have made a mistake.
This is my room.
Hercules will train a fetus to reign here with success.
Right here on ESPN.
Hercules was Chiron's close friend. He hasn't forgotten what's happened to him.
That took place years ago.
Hercules is honest, and honesty always finds the truth. Even after many years.
Is it Dr. No?
His purpose for coming here is to clear Chiron's
name. Is it the millionaire?
Perhaps he'll find something else more interesting. Mm-hmm. Emotions, for example. Love. Yole.
Oh, it's him, that guy, whoever it is.
Young people forget their purposes sometimes.
These kids today, I tell you.
Man, I say. You'll see.
I know.
Can I go to bed now?
I'll be going now to my hiding place. As you promised, it was the only reward I got.
And the gold?
The gold. But you need light to see it well. It's like blood on my hands. Bloody.
Pussy.
Like your brother was. Get out! Very well. Because I can wait till you want me.
Because I can wait till you want me.
And don't slam the screen door.
Don't!
It's the punk pass and kick competition. It's a Corvidal fantasy.
Would you two please stop that and get back to training, please?
I do solemnly swear.
No racing. I'm not joking. Your heart's strained. You can't force it.
I know, Esculapius, but I want to finish this marathon.
Better take him away.
But I was training for months.
Go on.
I wish I was a doctor.
They've all become fanatics since Hercules arrived. They seem to worship nothing but strength.
Their studies are neglected for the glory of the arena. Isn't that so, Orpheus?
Who are you?
Where it is for the moment poetry languishes.
Hey, can we play through?
And my lie will soon sing songs of nothing but heroes in battles. Why, look, Teepee, here's Argo.
He seems to be furious.
I'm furious.
Here in the arena? And have you all changed to his ways? Talk to the men. They speak only of Hercules.
He's won their hearts. They won't listen to me. To my way of thinking, he could start them battling against their elders.
No, Laertes.
Honey.
Just watch Hercules, a born master of these things. If he'll fight here, he can bring defeat to our enemies.
Hold your cards.
Look at him, standing with Castor and Pollux.
Ew.
Deceit does not go with a man of such qualities.
Hey, what are you guys looking at?
Look.
There goes one now.
Ta-da!
That's very good. A fine jump. But next time, try to end up on your feet. If you want to become champion, you must work.
I wanted you to notice me. I want to be like you, Hercules.
And you will be, my boy, because you have a strong will.
My father said you put strength ahead of everything, but I know you want us to use our forces only to serve our intelligence.
And you're right. All right. Now you will stay by my side, and I'll teach you to fight. But not only with your hand. And someday, your friends and enemies will honor you and name you the wise.
Hey, the pizza's here!
Hey, everybody, I just invented the shirt!
Somebody call a cab!
I might have known who it was. Fetus, forgive us, but don't you think it's time we go? He's here.
Until tomorrow.
He's perfect.
Judd Hirsch.
We better get to class, guys.
Skin bronzer, rhubarb, you know what I mean? Yeah.
Hey, suck it in!
Oh, see that guy sucking it in there? Mm.
Get a bow. The sun is high already. You sleep too much.
The pleasures I enjoy must aggravate you, but it's early. So please don't start that eternal nagging, simply because I delayed the great Hercules.
Hey, I worked hard for this body. Yeah.
Give me one of those.
Wait. Shoot where you are.
Miss
Noonan.
Hey, better.
Noonan.
My, you've certainly got a distinguished assembly of spectators.
Shoot the arrow.
Oh, he's left it way right of the green, Chris, over the gallery.
Why, this distance is nonsense. Is it your purpose to humiliate me so they'll talk?
In battle, at this distance, we'd call for the use of the bow. For shorter distances, the use of the sword or the spear. And remember, it's not a question of physical strength. With a little intelligence, even a boy like this one can hit a bullseye, standing where he is.
Better yet, prove it to me. Prove to me your head isn't just a mass of muscle up there.
Well, wait a minute now. My head is a mass of muscle.
Herc, honey, I brought you a sandwich and some clean underwear.
Oh, yole.
Lucky my chick's here.
Come on, nipples. Just drink in my back, huh? Who's idling her motor, huh?
What's he doing that for?
Keep still.
Oh, he always does this when they play miniature golf, too.
Now concentrate and listen to me. Aim before you wind up.
Keep your left arm
and
straight.
Watch the direction and intensity of the wind.
It ain't over till it's over.
Watch the tops of those trees.
And have some
fun. That will guide you to incline your bow at the proper angle.
The bow?
Once you've determined that,
determining
the arrow,
it? But this thing
it
with
will
the...
have to go straight out. Here's your bow.
Yes.
Now watch.
Oh.
Here. Oh, knock it off, Herc, every chance he gets.
Hoser.
I can do that.
Really smell nice today.
That's it.
Now let me get out of the way.
Just one more inch now.
I can't do it. You must do it. Steady now. One more foot.
An inch.
Shoot!
Wrong, wrong, wrong.
What's new, pussycat? Whoa!
A perfect shot at that.
I know him. I date him.
Well done, my boy. What's your name?
Ulysses, son of Laertes.
Remember what I'm going to say.
Perhaps someday,
a bow may decide your fate.
Now get out of here, you bum.
Listen, no one in all of this country has ever beaten me at discus throwing. All right, are you ready?
I accept.
Think fast.
If Aedas may win the discus throw, his body is built lighter than Hercules. That can work as an advantage sometimes.
We must wait and see.
Well, it's Clay Shaw.
Yep.
Would you just throw the discus?
Oh, yeah.
137 3/4.
I must say it's extraordinary.
Well, it will take some doing for Hercules if he ever wants to beat that record.
Now, just wait a minute.
Come, Hercules, we'd like to see your style.
I bet you
How
would.
Do you throw the discus at Thebes? With both hands?
Oh, that'll cost him some points.
Yes, let's see. It's just up and the... Yes, it's over and the... Yes, and when it's throwing the discus, it's... yes. Yes.
Oh, would you just?
Well, truly the hands of a god.
Look out, Escalade!
My chariot! My chariot! I want my chariot!
Okay, here you go, sir. Sir, you haven't validated it, sir!
Now don't go driving all crazy. It's not worth it. Oh, he's gone.
The totals on the board are correct. Before leaving, we urge you to check your immediate seating area.
Get out of my head, you! No!
Oh. He can beat anybody.
Oh, don't look at the naughty man. Come here.
I may be the winner, but I'm going home alone. Maybe not.
Well, I liked it.
Jolko. No, I want to enjoy the spectacle. Go away. I want to see you battling a lion, not throwing a discus around. Your tongue is faster than your sword. You take your orders from me. Go back. I'm responsible for your life. You're responsible for my prestige in front of the people, too. By the gods, I swear if you escape the lion, you won't escape this.
Oh, it all comes out at once with you.
Bozo the lion! Kitty.
Come on, you two. You're irritating the lion.
Oh, this is going real well.
Well, I seem to be okay. A few scratches. Oh!
You know, they never use their scratching posts.
No.
Claw balls, ladies and gentlemen. Claw balls.
I'll get the water pistol.
Come on, mix it up. I'm Herc.
Come on, Bert Lars a wimp. Come on.
Whoa.
You know, you pet them once, they won't go away.
Oh, you got a dry socket there, pal. Take me.
Oh, Herc, I was kidding.
Oh. Oh, I'm telling Joan Embry from the San Diego Zoo.
You know, either this man is dead or my sundial has stopped.
Well, it is noble to suffer the slings and arrows of the rage of thought.
Is this your design, O gods? Is this why I've come to Jolko?
Pretty much.
Hi, we came to get Scruffy, our pet lion. Oh, my God!
Your chariot arrived in Jolko like a messenger of death.
So to speak.
But it didn't tell you about the victim, I see. It may still be you, Hercules.
All right, boys, back to the precinct. Let's go.
So, lunch? Oh, yeah, you're dead, but still.
I told you, Peleus. I prophesied doom if you didn't send him away.
He's dead, my son. Oh, cruel gods.
Useless complaining to the gods. Plan your revenge now.
Avoid the rush.
Avenge my son, Hercules. I'll make Hercules suffer the way I suffer.
Listen to what I say to you.
Tunic is open in the rear. I can see your bike rack.
And if you just do that, you can forget he's invincible.
Your Highness!
Yeah!
Hercules has returned!
Oh, I'll alert the media.
It's Hercules. Why is everything Hercules? Ah.
Hey, boss, did you hear about Hercules?
Yes, I heard about Hercules.
Now what?
Hi, he broke. Sorry.
Could you give me a hand here?
Okay, who's gonna sign for this?
Careful. I'd recommend a cool storage place. You get him jerked.
Could I have his room, Dad?
I love my dead Greek son.
Our work here is finished.
Look, no charge, okay?
No one requested you to go after the lion.
He did it on spec.
If you hadn't been so headstrong, he would still be alive.
But anyway, it's still a nice day, huh?
The lion is vanquished.
The lion takes vanquish?
The parents of his victims feel grateful, I suppose. The danger is past them now.
Oh, wait.
But it can't placate me.
Go ahead, let it out. Come
you
on.
You want only your glory. You brought the gods' vengeance on my house. You'll atone for these things.
You'll atone for these things.
You bought the lion. You'll pay for the things you believe in. You'll do what I order you to. And I swear no man will help you.
I ain't helping you.
I charge you to meet the Cretan bull in battle. And may the curse of the gods be upon
you. Look, can I get a word in here?
Until you paid for the blood of a fetus.
You are dead, aren't you?
Oh, what a crummy 4th of July. Oh.
Sorry, ma'am. Got another show. Just, thanks.
Oops, saw him move. Just kidding, sorry.
Well, I see my chance.
So, why the long face? Kidding, of course, just breaking the ice.
Yoli, I didn't want to speak out against your father. But his punishment's unfair, and his accusations unjust.
And he's just so bogus.
Yes, I know. Hercules must listen only to the gods, because he cannot know the suffering of a woman.
Oh, yeah, it's a woman thing.
Listen to me, Yoli.
I don't want to. No way.
Maybe I'll call Samson, see what he's up to.
She likes me. Really?
Wait, you guys. The party's not over. I got plenty of cocktails left and the little umbrellas in them. Come on!
Well, I'm still immortal. They can't take that away from me.
Oh, yeah, I'll clean up the lion. Oh.
James A. Michener's Adventures in Hercules.
Oh, he's doing real good. He's got a paper route.
Mm-hmm. Oh, dang. On top of everything, my house is on fire.
Oh. Shane, come back, Shane.
Hey, what's for dinner, Hop Sing? Hmm?
There will be patches of scattered god today, followed by...
Why did a fetus have to die? Answer me, Sybil. I cannot understand. I'm greatly confused. A man I could crush with one hand gives me an order. A woman humiliates me.
It is not you who is to blame, Hercules. If Fetus died simply because he was not meant to be king of Jalka.
Oh, will you hand me the extinguisher?
Now the gods assign a new labor to you. They want you to go out and chance your fate against the Cretan bull.
Oh. Enough! I'm tired of doing all these senseless things for the gods. When will I be worthy in the eyes of the gods?
I'm in over my head
now
here!
Your fate is nearing. Don't rebel against it.
Now listen to me. These changes have happened to me in the last few days.
Male menopause.
Yoli, the way they punished me. All of these things helped me to feel in another way.
Oh, tingly.
I can't stand being superior. Let me experience the real things, love or hate.
Those are mortal states, Hercules.
If it's my immortality making me unhappy, then I'll do without it.
That's dangerous, Hercules. Don't you know how foolish you'd be to renounce it? To be born a man and see everything die is not to be immortal. Stay as you are. Be a god. Don't exchange immortality for fear, pain, and sorrow.
I want to live like any other mortal man.
Oh, brother.
It's my prayer to have a family.
A nice two-bedroom apartment,
I want
maybe.
Children of my own.
Herc is a 90s
to
woman.
To see the children growing up.
Pass on, Hercules.
You're barren, pal.
It's all as you ask. Now you shall have to confront your future and fight using only your own forces. Mortal victories, or you'll be defeated.
Joel, you remember the group Hamilton, Joe, Frank, and Reynolds?
Oh, sure, of course I do. They had two huge chart-busting hits when I was a kid in the 70s.
What were they?
Well, the first one was Don't Pull Your Love Out on Me, Baby, remember? Oh,
yeah. Don't pull your love out on me, baby! Yeah.
Sure, I remember that. What was the other hit?
I don't really remember the second one, except that it sounded a lot like Don't pull your love out on me, baby, right?
How many members did that band have?
Well, come on, Crow, that's easy. They were a quartet. Hamilton, Joe, Frank, and Reynolds.
Really? I always thought they were a duo. Hamilton, Joe, Frank, and Reynolds.
No, you guys, it was a trio. Hamilton, Joe, Frank, and Reynolds.
Wait! They were a quintet!
How do you figure that?
Well, Hamilton, Joe, Frank, and Reynolds.
But maybe if Ann Reynolds is one person, Tom, that would lead us all right back to the whole trio theory.
Well, with names like that, why the heck did they even name the band after themselves? Hamilton, Joe, Frank, and Reynolds does not exactly roll off the tongue like Dino, Desi, and Billy.
Joel, do you think we'll ever find the answer to the Hamilton, Joe, Frank, and Reynolds mystery?
Well, who can answer, my young friends? Who can really answer?
Well, Hamilton, Joe, Frank, and Reynolds.
Let's go!
Therefore, you may have come here.
Good morning.
Only to defraud me. I myself heard Kieran talk about the fleece. Your words can't influence me in what I must do. You've got enough unhappiness to my house. Do you want to take my throne now?
Well, maybe this will convince Peleus.
Would you just... look at the pins on him.
Athlete's foot, you!
Great legs, what do you think, huh?
Oh, yeah, nice ones.
I'd kill for those ankles.
If I may speak, I think this discussion is a waste of time.
No, Larry, you may not.
If this is Jason and he tells the truth, then we must ask the gods to prove it. The Chalcodes is a long journey. But if we persist and take this voyage, as I suggest, we might find the truth about King Aeson's death.
Howard Johnson is right.
I feel the gods favor us piercing the mysterious Chalcodes.
Ew!
It's perilous, and all our men shall need courage.
Courage.
For you see, for years we wanted an opportunity. And now we know the adventure for which Argo's ship was destined.
Who is he?
The poets will write about this in all the years to come.
Like Rod McEwen?
How we found the fleece of gold, or disappeared in the silence beneath us. Hmm. Let the people appraise the legitimate heir to the glorious throne of Jolko.
Hail Dorothy!
We'll be able to know who he is the day we come back.
Orpheus is right. I shall prepare the boat.
What
and
boat?
I shall go too. I also will go.
I too.
Do as you must. The gods have willed you to decide this.
Rip torn, ladies and gentlemen.
But don't expect me to wait here, tortured by doubt for the little time that I have.
And I'm not going to pick you up either.
There are 3 months to come back. Not one day more.
You kids will be the death of me.
I need a salty dog.
Has anybody seen my heels?
Eyes front, Carl.
Be assured of our help. What he says is true.
You can count on me.
You do look like King Aeson.
Of course.
Because he is Jason. Has anyone spoken of Ulysses? That's me. I'll introduce you. It's so nice that you let me go.
Hi, from the Fontainebleau Hotel.
Oh, that dress melts my fillings.
What do you want of me?
Do you have a quarter?
Don't think I'm being hostile to your father.
Isn't that funny? Then what should I think?
I'm only searching for the truth.
You can't handle the truth!
I feel the truth no longer matters after what you've done to him in there.
Listen to what I have to say. What I've done is for you.
I don't belong to you now. You'll listen to the words of Orpheus. There's a new mission to begin. One will be covered with success. Follow the one you named Jason then, and come back victorious like the adventurer you are.
Whoa, back off.
Do you remember what you said the first day we met?
I mean,
ew. That you couldn't be happy as long as the mystery of your uncle's death couldn't be cleared up. Listen, Yola. It's our destiny to solve it.
No, Hercules. Your destiny is not mine.
Better take a jump in that cold fountain, Herc.
Later, that same day...
You'll succeed, I'm sure of it. You'll return me with a golden fleece. I'll be accused. They'll kill us all.
Yay! Yay!
Very good.
Yes, yes.
Because she's mine.
stirring.
I saw that man without a sandal.
That's enough, Peleus. These lamentations aren't going to save you.
All right, then. Help us. Do you know any way to save us? I'm ready to do it.
If Jason's murdered,
yeah,
and since your son is dead, you must see. You can't expect your daughter to rule alone.
No, you shall never marry Yoli. Monster!
Their craft's almost ready to sail. I could be on it. Better think it over. Good night.
And now, funny man Morty Gunty.
Oh, you.
You want to eat or anything?
Nah, I'm gonna eat alone.
Nice day for it.
Looks like it's a big, brawny, hairy, glistening, two-fisted, manly day.
What a cheap cruise.
I want to be mortal. What was I thinking?
Huh? Dennis Day?
Any day.
Hercules, why don't you sing?
I'd rather not talk about it. Shut up.
Wager it's Yola, eh?
What was that supposed to mean?
You're not the man to act like that. First there's pain because she isn't
yours. Oh, why did I sit with this guy?
Then begins that jealous feeling. That passes after you're married, because then you're too tired to be jealous.
Shut up, steward!
Abe Lincoln looks cheesed here, huh? Mm.
What, did Herc get on a swing choir barge?
Here comes the wind. Get to the sails.
Oh, good, this is the fun part. I like this a lot better than rowing.
What are they doing?
The mighty canvas, like a giant skin hoisted aloft by sinewy hand.
Time goes slowly here at sea. I think I'll start a calendar. One notch for each day.
Well, now that's a good system. I would have done something like three notches, but he simplified it.
You'd think they'd be further away by now. They're barely past the dock.
Well, no plot on the horizon.
I wonder what I'm thinking about.
Where do you want these place settings, ma'am?
Will you be checking out today?
You don't speak anymore. You just keep looking out there.
Keep it up.
We're all sad, too. They never went this far before, I guess.
That's enough.
Geez, sorry for supporting you.
If you're gonna do an intervention, you're gonna have to be more persistent than that.
Man on the floor! Now, what did I come in here for?
You wait so anxiously while my fate is decided.
Yes, Father. We ask for only peace of mind.
Oh, and the car.
And if this boy is really Jason?
Well, he claims to me, but damn it, I know.
The throne is a burden. You even wanted to give it up, you said.
To begin over again, my child. No, I can't do it.
I know the gods will aid you. And Hercules.
Don't say that!
Oh, Daddy!
No. Yoli, I would like to wipe him out of your mind.
I'm not a hugger.
You guys should have thought about that before we left.
There go the dumbest group of guys you'll ever see. Look at them.
Mm. 12 angry Greeks.
Well, get moving. Get to work.
Geez, you gotta take orders from Pete Townsend in a dress.
Until later.
Yeah, don't look at our butts.
Okay.
Oh, boy. You know, the bigger they are, the nicer they are.
Their butts?
No, no.
Oh.
Oh, there you are.
Hey,
what a day, let me tell you.
You like Hercules? I think he's kind of a jerk.
Let's keep together. Better take this path.
Okay, we'll take this other path.
No, I said stay together.
C and H, pure cane sugar.
I can quit anytime.
It's a whoopee plant.
Guys, wait for me.
Attack of the Merry Martins.
Oh no, we're captured.
Joel, what was that shot about?
Stay there. What do you want on this island?
We presume the island was deserted. Some of us landed to find water and stock our provisions. Be assured our intentions are peaceful.
Throw down your arms and follow us. Queen Antea shall decide.
We surrender.
Wow, just think what they could have hit if they felt like it. Oh.
Come on, they could never do that again. Not in a million years. They go, oh, oh!
Even the archers are beautiful.
Why not? Might prove interesting.
Not the tunics, guys.
Follow me.
Where I go, what I am, who I know.
It's a wacky sitcom.
Or a wacky satiricon.
Vung.
Hey, Skipper, look what I found.
Say what your name is.
Come here often?
Isn't everybody here phony?
Don't you ever talk?
She's an Ellen Jamesian.
But it's unbelievable that at 60 I'm taking part in an adventure like this one. Oh, thank you, Aphrodite.
Jupiter, they're real, all right? I always thought it was a legend, the kind of nonsense invented by poets.
Yeah, we hear that a lot.
What do you mean? Who are they?
They are the Amazons, if you want to know. The population is female, absolutely all girls.
Women.
A society similar to the bees.
Did you ever hear how the drones finish? Who finish?
Yes, the male bees of the tribe. The females kill them at the mating season.
Look at that.
It's us.
Right. And only men.
It's the Andrea Dworkin Memorial Cemetery.
They came to island for food and provisions.
Landed here, loved here, and died here.
Sounds okay to me.
A pity.
That's great. Maybe we should run!
Let's not forget. Who said life sometimes hangs by a thread?
Bill Baird?
Shall we be alive tomorrow? Who's able to say? So it's best to be happy today.
Who are you, Bobby McFerrin?
It's the Bataan Sex March.
It's Little Big Man.
Oh, they're gonna carve Mount Rushmore.
We've landed on the island of annoying music.
Gee, I wonder what it costs to heat this place.
Oh, great. There's a big line at check-in.
Land of the Bee Arthurs.
Wow, that's quite a lobby.
I surrender.
Guess what's for dinner?
Man, which was
yeah.
It's the Percy Faith Orchestra.
Esther Williams.
Oh, I've been sucking it in for an hour. I'm really glad you're here.
Hail to you, milady. Be assured that these men and I from another land come in peace to your island.
Yeah, right. Kill them.
Our aim is simple. All we want are supplies and provisions.
And a room somewhere.
I feel you may be ironic. You see, the Amazon people are dying out. As you know, we are all women. We have lost our men. They were all killed years ago when they went up the mountainside. An earthquake took them. Now we remain alone here.
Very alone.
Pity us for the way we are now.
Gee, I feel bad.
You'll find we are valuable allies.
Excuse my indiscretion.
But that bard.
I am called Jason.
Oh, what are you doing?
We are from Jalco. This is Argo, Pollux, Laertes, Castor, and Aesculapius.
And Steve.
We were sailing to the Chalcides, but a storm forced us to throw our provisions overboard, and you see, we never tried.
You shall stay till tomorrow, and then go.
And remember, checkout is at noon.
Now you listen to what I tell you.
Isn't she great?
Put at the stranger's disposition all our wine and all our food.
Yeah!
Yes!
Yes!
What did I tell you?
You didn't say what your name is.
They call me Mr. Tibbs.
My name is Antea. Now you know.
Would it be insolent if I asked about the earthquake story?
I beg your pardon?
You said the story was that the earthquake killed all the Amazon men. But on the way here, Laertes told it to me.
So what's the deal?
Only, according to him, it happened 100 years ago.
And you want to know about how we survived, women living here alone?
Lots of bathrooms.
Well,
fine.
Let me teach you to swim.
Oh, you're drunk.
Really? I saw the lake as we were coming up here. You'll enjoy it.
I must admit, we were frightened at first. Your marksmanship was perfect.
When I finally lowered the sail...
Hey, it's a mixer.
You feel it counts, not the number of years you have.
And that's when I got into collecting spoons. You?
Several years after the eruption...
Excuse me?
...seafaring men came here. And they were welcome, needless to say. But we were paid back with violence and cruelty.
But enough about me.
Taught us a lesson. Then... the women formed themselves into an army.
He's pretending he's interested.
Now we make sure the women aren't hurt.
Of course.
Before they were, but no man
you
now.
You kill all the men.
Mm-hmm.
It proves to us that we're superior.
Oh, yeah, that's really interesting.
Men mean nothing anymore for
oh,
us.
What do you know?
If that's I should something. Die tomorrow, I'd be happy to have sacrificed and dedicated all to be the queen of this island.
Really?
But don't your women ever fall in love?
Don't you see? Love's an expression never used here.
Except when it comes to chocolate.
Time past. Please.
But you're joking. You must be. Tell me, do you really hate us?
Yes.
Women know what you want. Filled only with your own desires.
And watching football.
The gods have created us Amazons purposely to punish you for your wrongs.
No, punish
Not
me, please.
Not all men are alike. Some men are full of kind sentiments.
Like Alan Alda.
Not just desires. You know, a woman is incomplete without a man.
Zing!
Ah,
my spine!
The Ooh Lagoon.
I see Sparta, I see Athens, I see someone.
I'd like to do a scene from Baywatch, if I may.
By all means.
Now, don't you kids get drunk and go swimming under the dock. Help! I'm drunk and I'm swimming under the dock! Baywatch. Baywatch.
Stay away from their powerful hind legs. She's nude.
When Congress goes swimming.
What, did we tap into the Playboy Channel?
And so the men of the Calypso are all painted bronze. Falco cries when in Rome and dives into the water.
One more.
Eleanor Donahue.
Oh, you know, you're really so greedy.
You mean greeky.
But why did we meet like this?
You wouldn't leave me alone.
Brought to me by a strange adventure, I was to have another destiny.
Your destiny brought you to me.
Destiny rides again.
You're so ambitious. Be happy in this place.
But I feel we must get away. Somewhere, just the two of us together. Living like men do everywhere else.
In the suburbs.
And suffering.
Don't go if, as you say, there is so much suffering.
Yeah, I got mine. Who cares?
You may go, but here's where I belong.
I'll be here with you.
The flowers are talking to them.
It's all that I want, just to be with you like this. To stay by you. To taste your kisses, hear your voice. I can't live without you.
Which trip was better?
I'd give 10 years of my life to solve this mystery.
There's no mystery. It's perfectly clear. They enjoy
oh,
the
show.
Oh,
that guy's got a saggy diaper that leaks over
Hercules,
there.
Hercules, Ulysses, and Orpheus are aboard, and we see them. The others know. They've been gone a week or more.
Oh, that's for Gene Wilder.
Hello. Sneak, little boy. Hello.
Yumptious wax fruit.
Dear Ulysses, don't eat the fruit. It's poison.
Buttery napalm.
But you must know that I love you.
Your feelings are no concern of ours.
Uh-oh, this has turned into
the
a porky.
The term has expired many days ago. The law is the law, and it must be obeyed by all of us.
Oh, lady,
you know that the law applies to you as well. More to you, Antea. Those men shall all be put to death. And do it by tomorrow morning. Jason will be the first. He must not live to see the sunrise. You must act quickly, before the dawn.
I shall do as the gods command.
Women, kill! I'm warning!
I'm not going back, Jim!
The naked prey.
Come on, wake up, you boozy old sex fiend. They're gonna kill us all!
What's that?
Waking? I don't understand. I'm dead nappy time.
Will you wake up, please? It's important.
What's more important than sleeping?
I must Except know what food medicine and I sex. Can use.
Grass seeds of poppies is what I recommend. The poppy seeds and wine is the most effective thing I know. Hmm?
Poppies!
Like this one?
Huh? Yes.
Thank you.
There's grown a victory garden there.
Yay, team. Previously, I'll forget it.
Thank you.
Well, this ought to pick up the movie.
Think it'll rain if it stays like this?
Here comes Ulysses.
Look at the poor dope.
Well, I guess I'll go make breakfast then.
Did I ever tell you I used to be immortal? Mm-hmm. Oh, really?
Well, I hope my beverage works. Hmm?
Should we wake the guys?
No, this is our time.
Times like these are made...
Well, will you look over there? That's something suspicious. Planning something again.
Sneaking away to visit those Amazons.
Who can blame them, though, huh?
We have to stay on board like slaves. Oh, keep quiet, will you?
Keep still, all of you. I want to sleep.
I've got a voiceover tomorrow.
Whoa. That's naughty!
The Solid Gold Dancers.
Mike Brady.
Can I get another Grulch over here?
I always get this way at out-of-town conventions.
Remember, there's a 30-drink minimum.
They're having a collective episode.
Sure, it's for the men, but I like it too.
Grapefruits.
Grapefruits, wonderful grapefruits.
Grapefruits.
Delicious ruby red Indian river.
Why is nectar so potent, my dear? You look to me like you're two girls. Because you're looking at me with such a sad expression. But then everyone looks so melancholy and they're dancing. But we're not going to a funeral this morning.
Boring. I love the way he tells stories.
How's yours?
Not good.
It's a Who from Whoville.
Signal Cindy to rescue us.
Grapefruits.
Grapefruits, fresh.
They're not just for breakfast anymore.
Delicious, juicy lemon pulp. Nom, nom, nom. And delicious grapefruits.
They are really good tonight.
If you could just continue.
Yeah, I'll see you in hell.
I feel so strange for a minute.
Insert juicy grapefruit.
We really unclog you, grapefruit. For juicing and for smile slices. All right, now for the abdominals. Thank you.
Don't go away.
I can't, sir. House rules. I'm sorry.
You act like we're all gonna die or something.
Oh, her face is drawn to Polar North.
Did you have a Caesar salad for lunch?
I know we've been dating for an hour, but I need my space.
Oh, man, that thing is really pinching her arm there.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Satellite of Love, in association with Maboo Mines, the Wooster Group, Theatre de la Jeune Lune, and the Burt Reynolds Jupiter Dinner Theater, proudly presents the critically acclaimed tour de force, wherein one robot single-handedly portrays Gene Rayburn, plus all the contestants on the match game. I'm Tommy Olsen. Ladies and gentlemen, we give you Crow T Robot, starring in Give 'em Hell Blank.
Hi, I'm Gene Rayburn. Welcome back to the match game. Well, let's get right to our next round, shall we? Lena said to Oli, name the two happiest days of your life. Oli said, that's easy. The day I bought my boat and the day I blank. The day I bought my boat and the day I blank. Okay, let's see what we got up there. Charles Nelson Reilly.
I was going to say hinder.
All right, Brett Summers.
I wrote down derriere.
Richard Dawson. Survey says gluteus maximus. Betty White.
I wrote down patootie.
Fanny Flag.
Appropriately enough, I wrote down Fanny.
And Nipsey Russell. Well, Oli was a chump. Lena said this place is a dump. But I'm gonna say, rump! Well, let's see if there were any other matches, because we're running out of time. And I'm afraid time was running out for me, too. Those were happy, carefree days. I thought I'd host Match Game forever. But alas, it was not meant to be. Don't get me wrong, wish only the best for Ross Schaefer. But the truth is that old game show hosts like me or a dying blank. Charles Nelson Reilly? Can you hear me? Brett Summers, are you out there? Richard Dawson, where are you? Fanny Flagg, answer me. Betty White, speak to me. Nipsey Russell, don't leave me like this, alone and afraid. There is no creature loves me. And if I die, no soul shall pity. Wherefore should they, since I myself find in myself no pity to myself? Please, God, don't do this to me. Don't kick me in the patootie. Ah, who the heck am I to feel sorry for myself? My show brought laughter and joy to millions. I've had a good life. Good night, folks.
Okay.
Spread
out, I'll handle this.
Hercules!
Yo!
Turn the boat around. We want to go back to the island.
Orpheus, Ulysses, take the tiller.
The tiller?
I've decided to go ahead.
What?
I said I've decided to go ahead.
You can hear their civil defense sirens.
What are you waiting for?
Me? I have a very sick friend I must visit.
I don't get a day job.
I don't get it.
So long, farewell, our feet are sin.
Come on.
Come on, man the oars.
Or the man, so...
It's a Gap Jeans commercial.
Orpheus, let's have a song.
A song.
Liar, liar.
All of you, sing along with us. I need wind in the sail.
Herc's getting lusty and oily again. Let's hit it, fellas.
Oh, yeah, this is way better than being on the island.
Maybe if we go back higher up, we won't hear Gordon McRae down there.
I don't like this any more than you do.
Sad, really.
Your Ohio State Buckeyes!
Oh, knock it off, Hercules.
Well, we forgot the words to this part.
Oh, see, they're still there.
Maria Callas.
musical song.
Sail away!
Boom, 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 boom.
It's carving a piano.
Oh. Ding, 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 ding,
ding. Hey, oars are supposed to be broad and flat. No wonder they're not getting anywhere.
If this be the Colchides.
Let me live it as a blonde.
This is near us.
Why do they go ashore so early? Couldn't they wait for daylight?
Maybe there's Amazons on the island.
Keep Jason from going. The others follow.
It's a busy off-ramp.
This island bites. It's like totally Amazonless.
We surrender! Anybody?
We're ready to be captured!
It's Swiss family Papadopoulos.
How about a song, Herc?
Yeah, there's probably a strip mall there now.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Commando Cody. Mm-hmm.
Hey, this is real fun, Herc.
It's great. No, really, it is.
Ooh, hey, hairy dudes. Ooh. Hey, it's the Jim McNatowski, Tommy Chong, Gilbert Gottfried, Gino Vanelli tribe.
Well, they're not Amazons, but when in Rome, fellas.
Hey, honey.
Thank you, Hercules. This is wonderful.
Man, they're really not very good savages, are they?
Unorganized.
Yeah, and on top of that, they all look like the Nutty Professor.
Don't touch the hair!
Here, give them to me after everything myself.
Oh, hello.
Is something out of a bad dream?
Jim Cutter! Up, Jim Cutter!
Huh, must be time for savage supper.
See? This can still be fun.
Okay, how about a song?
Jason. Where is Jason?
Oh, he's reading comics up in the bushes again.
Jason!
Oh, good thing they left the Golden Fleece out to dry.
A lone ram committed suicide today.
Can I help you, sir?
Oh, wait, I thought they said golden grams, not golden ram.
Hey, I feel the earth move under my feet.
Gilligan!
Mulch strikes back.
Oh, nice doggy. Oh, good pooch. Oh.
I thought those things were extinct.
It's the future site of Jurassic Industrial Park.
Hmm.
Throw him a milk bone!
Big one!
Finally, a cool part.
Welcome to the land before time.
Man, I'd hate to see his litter box.
Look, I don't need the Golden Fleece. You keep it.
Why must I lash out at everyone I meet?
Hey, I just want to borrow the Golden Fleece.
No.
Could I just try it on?
You can see why this film isn't good for the tourist trade.
Negotiations for the fleece continued into the night.
Oh, come on, he just wanted to play.
Oh boy. Oh, that really. Oh, golly. Oh, boy. Whoa. Oh,
creature. The money is in that.
You know, that monster never read getting to yes.
Mm-hmm. How's he going to strap that dinosaur to the top of his car?
It's a bath mat. What do they want with a bath mat?
Oh, really up close, it's not really that golden. It's kind of more of a burnt umber.
Ross, yeah.
Wash separately in cold water, hang to dry. Oh.
My brother killed me. Hmm? Peleus, wow, on the talks. Hand that struck me as I slept. May the gods forgive him for what he did.
How could he have written it after he died?
May they persecute and curse him if he harms my son.
Oh, I've read this one.
Into your hands, O gods, and I ask of you to free his thoughts from revenge, for no more blood must be shed.
Now, wouldn't that dinosaur love to hear that now?
Thank you, gods. Thank you so bloody much.
What?
Yours was the deed of a king. We acknowledge you as sovereign of Jolko.
Were you watching all this time?
What is written on the back of the golden fleece? On whom will our vengeance fall?
On no one.
On no one.
It was the last request of the king.
Play Stardust.
It is his will. He pities those who take revenge. You'll return this to Jolko.
For sore credit.
You'll place the golden fleece behind the throne.
O king, it's wise to forgive. But you'd be wiser to look deep into the eyes of the man you've forgiven.
I follow only what my father commands and my conscience dictates.
You got a plastic bag for this thing? Maybe a wooden hanger?
I must do it. I'll take the responsibility.
I'll walk it and feed it and call it gold.
Sit. Stay. Good, please. Good.
Yeah, he'll probably send a UPS.
And now, before your very eyes, the golden fleece will escape from this trunk in just minutes.
Wow, look, it's been it's been a long time.
2,000 flushes.
Hey, Mom, Dad, hi! I love camp. You should have seen this one island. There were girls and stuff.
Respective honeys, we're home!
We made it in 3 months. Where's Hercules, do you know?
We thought he was with you.
There he is. Look, Ulysses.
Oh, Hercules, the first postal worker.
Where is the golden fleece?
Stolen from under our noses. Dun, dun, dun.
I'm back and I'm mad as hell.
Listen, now beware of Jason. Jason is king. Jason will judge you. Don't forget that we'll fight. You will never beat Jason. Don't be too sure, because the golden fleece is ours now. That's enough! Everybody will know you're thieves!
Going down, Mr. Hercules?
Hey, no one said they had one of those.
Yeah, typical. While the rest of us are unloading, Hercules is nowhere to be found, man. Bites.
This is my room!
What is this for?
You're not to leave your room. The king's orders.
Orders, you say?
And just how long am I grounded?
Tell me, where is Hercules?
We know nothing about it.
Right, God.
But that's ridiculous, bolting us in this way.
Don't be worried, Yole. Now that Jason's here, they'll decide who the king of Jolko is.
Yole! Hercules!
Malcolm X is over there.
In there, locked up. Watch the sentry.
I always do.
Oh, this set is for their big closing number.
Daddy, there's a bunch of boys outside.
No, wait, look back. Shut up, shh, quiet.
That will keep him quiet for a while.
So anyway, do you like my helmet?
You know, it's hard for them to get any flatter against that wall.
That guy's always been asking me out. I don't want to see him. Here, wait, let me help. It's better if I do. It hurts. I got it.
That is a lumpy mattress.
Mm-hmm. Hercules.
Can I have the checkbook?
Oh, good one.
The door does not open from the inside. We are trapped in here like he is.
That's why it's called a prison.
No, he's still alive.
You report that your journey has been successful.
Yeah, pretty much.
That you found the Colchides. And in the Colchides you found the Golden Fleece. May I look at it?
No.
Where is Hercules?
Where isn't Hercules?
What has Hercules got to do with it? If I give up my throne, I must have your proof. Not Hercules.
Tell me, I demand it.
You already assume the tone of a king.
Herc had Herc. Where Herc? Who Herc? Duh, huh?
But now you dare to issue commands. Bring to me the fleece, and I will give you the throne. But I promise that if I find you have lied to me, you will be condemned and put to death.
All and I
you.
Mean it this time.
I told you, the fleece has been stolen. You can ask your own men here.
Ta-da.
They're your partners if it comes to that. I want the fleece now. The fleece is yours, show it to me.
Actually, it's Thinsulate.
I know you can't. Because you're an imposter and your men are traitors. Arrest them all.
You have the right to remain silent.
Hey, somebody find the fleece!
Well, Gary had it last.
I gave it to Rick.
Oh, you.
No wonder I had a hard time sleeping. The hell?
Okay. Oh, my.
No, I knew it. Now we'll be dragging those around the house.
Thanks, buddy.
You got it, pal. Ooh, right in the granitological area.
The granular region.
Man, it must be south central Greece.
Later, I'm a little busy right now.
I'm Herc and I'm irked.
I can explain everything.
Why didn't anybody wake me?
Ah, miss me, now you gotta kiss me.
Oh, he's gonna have to wear a turtleneck for the next week.
What are you doing? Keep away from me! Ow!
I'm climbing halfway through hell in Greece just to find some stupid sheepskin and... Oh, God, I hate these things! Oh!
Hercules! Well, he's just invented the weed whipper!
Weed whipper?
Oh, you're here.
Hey, thanks for throwing in, Gramps.
That came out of nowhere.
This is a weird chain of events.
Chains don't kill people. Hercules kills people.
It's not worth it, fellas. Let's meet in the break room.
Boy, Herc can really clear a room.
Taste it all. Diet hemlock.
I have a delicious poison in the morning, and that's it.
Yeah, that's acrylic.
No, it's a well-done golden fleece.
Dad, let me guess. Something's wrong.
Yoli.
Lady.
Pardon me. Men sometimes make mistakes. And now mine have caught up with me.
That's what Michael Milken probably said.
So badly. Jason should reign in Jalko.
Men are such babies when they have a head cold.
Tell me about everything now. You mustn't lie any longer.
My dear, it's useless. The poison's working well.
Poison! Father!
That was mine!
You mustn't regret anything, daughter.
But Dad, before you die, will you sign my report card?
Go away with Hercules. He's a good man.
You know, if you would have said that a half hour ago, none of this would have happened.
Now, gods take me to the land of shadows. May I be forgiven.
School's out for the summer.
Well, that chain thing is still working real well.
This morning, a lone chainman terrorized downtown Athens. No motive was apparent.
Well, not this again. Anytime something doesn't go his way...
This is how he always closes his act.
Is that a supporting beam? Good. That'll do. The National Guard was called in to help quell the violence.
Hey, Herc, we were coming to congratulate you!
Mr. Hercules, they just surrendered and gave us the palace.
Oops. Well,
we probably should have gotten out first, huh?
Oh, man, if this were in Sensoron, this would be so great.
Well, we could vibrate.
Ooh.
All right, we're leaving. All you had to do was say something. Jeez.
Now there is justice, and the clouds over Jolko pass away. Hmm. Out of great sorrow and spilled blood, forces of good are sometimes born. Hercules and Yole are leaving now to find a new happiness.
6 fun-filled weeks in Jamaica.
The race of men, where justice and peace will be with them again. Farewell, Hercules.
Bye now.
Farewell, Yole. Life awaits you, with all its glory and all its shadows.
Go forth, graduates.
But even through the most difficult tasks, the gods may prepare for you.
Herc and Yole really had a rocky dating and engagement period.
The end of time.
So, like, you want to grab a bite or maybe lay out on the Lido deck or something?
Or is it?
I doubt it.
Whatever happened to these guys?
I don't know. It's kind of inconclusive.
Oh, I know. You see, Hercules got a job as a prep cook for a while, but he got fired for toking up on the job. And he said it was just because the manager didn't like the Greeks. And Yole did dead entry at Fingerhut.
Did they have any kids?
Oh, no. Herc couldn't perform his husbandly duties, if you know what I mean. Well, they adopted Ulysses, but he became a real troublesome kid. You know, he busted into a cabin up north and took some fishing gear. He was on probation for a while. We always got connections to a string of chop shops.
But Hercules and Yole really loved each other, right?
Well, it depends on how you define love. You know, for Yole, it got really hard to come home from Fingerhut night after night, see this big demagogue sitting on the couch, slamming back linies and watching TV. Mm-hmm. Well, then Herc went through rehab, and he started selling Kirby's door to door. And one day, he ran into an Amazon he knew from the island, this Debbie. Pretty soon, Debbie was calling him at home all hours and driving past his house and stuff all the time. Yole just flipped out, and then she left and took Ulysses.
And Jason? Oh, what about Jason?
Well, Jason, he sold the Golden Fleece and bought himself a Rupp mini bike. Ooh. His family moved a lot, so he was in and out of schools, never in one place for more than a couple of months. Well, he quit school at 15 and started doing stand-up comedy on the road. Then one night he freaked out on stage after some guy heckled him about Madea. Mm-hmm. Not to mention that, you know, he refused to drive the headliner to Fargo one time, so he didn't get much work after that. Then he was killed in a tragic boating accident involving the Argo, and, you know, there were some taunts from cruel crewmates, and there was a case of St. Pauli girl involved.
Are you done?
Really sad. No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
But what about that Crayon? You remember Crayon? He was the one who went out to the...
Tommy boy, by my calculations, that comes out to be about 15 Amazon women apiece.
Yeah, okay, so it's 15 apiece. I admit those are good odds, but what good would it be? Who wants a bunch of dumb old girls around? I mean, there'd be curling irons all over the bathrooms and hair clogs in the showers, not to mention them wearing our shirts.
Huh. Tom, are you even paying attention? It seems pretty obvious to me that if Amazon women were to take over the ship, you and I would not have to lift a finger. They'll cook, they'll clean. They'll empty the load pans, squeegee the windows, and peel grapes for us and feed them to us. They even like to go horseback riding and swimming.
Ooh.
Wow. Well, when you put it that way, I guess I could put up with a few nylons hanging in the bathroom, you know? Boy, all our chores done, snacks on demand, lunch every day, kiss bye. Man, we'd have it made.
I know, okay, I know.
Okay, listen, you guys. I've heard every word you said, and I want you to know it makes me just sick.
What? Wow, we were just saying that Amazon women love to do stuff for men.
Listen, in the first place, you're not men, you're robots. In the second place, not all women carry curling irons around. And in the third place, you've got Amazons all wrong. It's like they were noble warriors that didn't need men at all. Mm. It just so happens that the filmmakers decided to take a few liberties with ancient Greek history and add some sexual titillation, and you rummies bought it. Mm. Oh, we got a ship coming into range. Give me rocket number 9. Hey, who are you?
Oh, hi, I'm Elaine, and this is Carol. You know, I must have taken a wrong turn at the Piggly Wiggly. You know, we're looking for the paper drive.
Well, I can see by your T-shirt that you're an Amazon.
Card carrying since 67. Jeffrey gave us these T-shirts. He's my Cindy's youngest. cute. I am telling you, that well, kid.
That's great, Doc. Could you tell us if you're going to conquer us or take us over or something?
Oh, heavens no. Who's got the time? It used to be a full-time thing. Now we just conquer men for charity. It's real, real fun.
Well, in that case, maybe you could help my friends and I get out of space and take us back to Earth or something.
Oh, no, mister. You boys knew you were going to be in space. You should have arranged a ride. I am not Mom's taxi.
Yeah, you kids can walk. It's nice out.
Well, listen, we gotta run. It's nice meeting you fellas. Bye-bye. Nice kiss. Huh.
So, those were Amazons, eh? Nice, but not at all what I expected.
No, not at all.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, me neither. Jeez, they seemed like somebody's moms or something. She said they were semi-retired, but still I imagined an Amazon being a noble warrior with one cut off and listen, I'm not feeling very good. Let's hurry up with the meds and I'm gonna lay down. You can make me a soup and sandwich.
Good idea. Come in, sirs, please.
Oh, Frank, bring me that memo. Oh, Frank, bring me some coffee. Yes, I'm Dr. Forrester. I'm king of the whole world. Sorry, I didn't mean to. I was just about to
push the button, perhaps.
You know me so well.
Something out of a bad dream.